James Webb Telescope detected something chilling at the edge of the universe. It has captured something eerie, something sinister lurking on the rim of the universe. Join us as we go on an adventure in which hypotheses will be tested and the limits of our knowledge will be tested. So buckle up, because this is one journey you won't want to miss. Have you ever wondered what makes up 85% of all stuff in the universe, and which remains one of contemporary physics' greatest mysteries? Enter dark matter. Despite being an essential component of galaxy formation, we have never directly witnessed it since. It emits no light. But what if there was a breakthrough, a finding that altered all we thought we understood about this? James Webb Telescope detected something chilling at the edge of the universe. The spacecraft has transmitted a picture that may help to answer the enigma of dark matter and one of our time's most difficult challenges. Dark matter, an invisible element that only exposes itself by its gravitational force, is thought to make up a startling quarter of the whole universe, dwarfing all visible matter such as galaxies, stars, and planets. It may appear astonishing that we are still unaware of what constitutes the vast bulk of our cosmos. Despite its prevalence in the universe, the mysterious material has eluded direct discovery to this day. For many years, physicists assumed that the expansion of the cosmos would ultimately come to a halt. However, when NASA's Hubble telescope gazed into space, it saw something very unexpected. The universe was really growing at a faster rate. This revelation has astrophysicists scratching their heads and debating various hypotheses. They ultimately came to the astonishing conclusion that dark matter and dark energy make up 95% of the universe. Invisible occurrences that have a visible impact on the planet. Although the James Webb Space Telescope cannot literally sense dark matter, we can perceive it. Experts think it will be able to evaluate its influence on its surroundings and will have revealed the universe's most significant mysteries. And as it turns out, the James Webb Space Telescope has just accomplished it. The James Webb Space Telescope is a technical marvel with a gigantic 6.5-meter main mirror and an astonishing capacity to zoom in on distant objects for astrophysicists investigating dark matter. This implies that the telescope may use a method known as gravitational lensing, in which the bulk of a galaxy bends the light from galaxies behind it, allowing it to capture images of distant galaxies. The James Webb Space Telescope can assist scientists in determining the overall mass of the nearby galaxies by measuring how much light from the background galaxies bends and comparing the expected mass of those foreground galaxies to what the James Webb Space Telescope measures. Researchers were able to calculate the quantity of dark matter in the galaxy. Now, astrophysicists in Italy have used the James Webb Space Telescope to offer fresh insight on the nature of matter. The discovery of galaxies 13 billion years ago, as well as innovative state-of-the-art numerical simulations of the early galaxies. While the commonly accepted structure creation paradigm is predicated on non-relativistic matter that interacts purely gravitationally, especially cold dark matter, alternative solutions promoted to tackle small-scale issues in the conventional scenario rely on the hypothesis that dark matter is formed of heated particles with a tiny non-negligible thermal velocity, termed warm dark matter. According to Dr. Umberto Mayo, staff researcher at the Italian National Institute of Astrophysics NAF Astronomical Observatory of Trieste and lead author of the paper, we discovered that the recent James Webb Space Telescope galaxy detections in the first fraction of a billion years after the Big Bang are valuable probes of the nature of matter. According to the results, dark matter, the fundamental ingredient of matter in the cosmos, is formed of particles with masses more than 2 keV that are either cold or merely faintly heated. Dark matter models with particle masses equal to or less than this limit are excluded from the investigation. Using the most recent James Webb Space Telescope data and a highly advanced numerical simulation of early galaxy formation, the researchers were able to discriminate between alternative theories by studying the statistical tendencies of primordial galaxies. According to Dr. Umberto, the observable qualities of the universe's structures, the mass of the dark matter particle influences the formation of the earliest stars and galaxies. The study discovered that cosmic star formation, ultraviolet luminosities, and chemical abundances differ in various dark matter theories, and that the most recent James Webb Space Telescope data may be utilized to compare these differences. This is a significant use of scientific data at such early epochs to restrict the nature of dark matter. We have observed the most distant galaxies because of James Webb Space Telescope. Aside from this investigation into the nature of dark matter, an astronomer at Oxford University has presented another proposal that may eventually explain the long-standing riddle. Jamie Farnes argues that dark matter and dark energy may coexist as a black fluid of negative masses with negative gravity that pushes objects away rather than drawing them towards it. Dr. Barnes, who is an astrophysicist, according to Barnes's theory, published in Astronomy and Astrophysics, seeks to explain some of the universe's strange traits, such as how galaxies spin so quickly that they should rip themselves apart, yet dark matter halos prevent such annihilation. According to the idea, negative mass dark fluid may cause these halos to develop. However, this poses a problem if dark energy grows less dense over time. Observations indicate that it remains reasonably constant in order to solve this. Another scientist offers the idea of matter generation, which states that more and more matter perpetually bursts into existence, replenishing the negative matter that vanishes. His work uses an intriguing parallel to demonstrate his thesis. It's a beautiful image. Space-time is like a bowl of popcorn, with negative masses exploding into existence in the same manner that kernels pop into fluffy popcorn. However, the black fluid hypothesis remains just a theory based on mathematical models and computer simulations. Other scientists are correct in approaching it with skepticism. While the theory appears to explain certain aspects of the cosmos, the fundamental question is whether it can explain all of the other data. We have Geraint Lewis, professor of astrophysics at the University of Sydney, who warns that many tests must be performed before we can conclude whether this theory bears up to our existing understanding of the cosmos. Aside from these beliefs, scientists have established a persuasive argument that the observable universe, which includes Earth, the Sun, other stars, and galaxies, is made up of protons, neutrons, and electrons packaged into atoms. One of the most startling findings of the 20th century was that ordinary or baryonic matter amounts for less than 5% of the mass of the cosmos. In contrast, the remainder of the universe appears to be composed of dark matter. As previously established, dark energy is a force that repels gravity. Dark matter has yet to be directly seen by scientists since it has no interactions with baryonic matter and is entirely undetectable to light and other types of electromagnetic radiation. Dark matter is therefore impossible to detect with present technologies, although scientists think it exists owing to gravitational forces. It appears to have an effect on galaxies and clusters of galaxies. Stars in the galactic center, where a galaxy's visible mass is concentrated, should travel far slower than those towards the edge of a spinning spiral galaxy. Observations, however, demonstrate that stars orbit at nearly the same speed. This baffling conclusion makes sense regardless of where they are in the galactic disk if the border stars are subjected to the gravitational forces of an undiscovered mass dark matter and a halo around the galaxy. Some scientists believe that by modifying the fundamental rules of gravity, the influence of dark matter on the universe may be clarified. They imply that there are many types of gravity, and that the gravity that regulates galaxies on a massive scale varies from the gravity we normally experience. Physicists originally believed that gravity would halt the expansion of the universe. When two separate teams monitored the rate of deceleration over time, they discovered that the expansion was speeding up. It's like tossing keys up and expecting them to fall back down. However, they fly straight up to the ceiling. If you are enjoying the video so far, hit the subscribe button for many such fascinating videos such as this. Scientists currently believe that the universe's fast expansion is driven by a repulsive force created by quantum fluctuations in empty space, and that this force is becoming stronger as the universe expands. Many scientists think that the known qualities of dark energy correspond to a cosmological constant, which is a mathematical addition to Albert Einstein's theory of general relativity. To match his equations with the concept of a static cosmos, Einstein hypothesized that the constant would be a repulsive force that counteracts gravity and prevents the cosmos from collapsing in on itself. However, when Einstein learned that the universe was expanding, he abandoned the theory. As a result, using dark energy as a cosmic constant might virtually explain how space-time is being stretched. Experts still don't understand why the odd force exists. Want to find more about James Webb Telescope? Then the video, Big Bang is Over, James Webb Telescope finds hint of another universe at the edge of the universe, is for you.